Hello and welcome to another episode of the After Work Anime Club podcast. I'm your host Lulu Soul, and co-hosting with me today is going to be Salvo Sharko.
Hello, yes. Hello.
So, Salvo, you have actually not been in a podcast since we started the new format.
Admittedly, I was busy for a bit.
You were busy for a bit. What we do with the podcast right now, or a format that I'm playing around with, is you and I have watched the anime trailer, or the trailer of an anime that neither of us have seen. We're going to talk about that trailer and what we are expecting from the anime, and then we are going to watch three episodes of that anime, after which we're going to come back to the podcast. So for us, it'll be like an hour and a half, but for all of you wonderful viewers out there, it'll be almost instantaneous. And then we're going to talk about how the trailer compares to the first three episodes of the anime and whether or not it passes the vibe check. What do you think?
I mean, sounds fun to me. Let's do it.
Awesome. So we have seen the trailer of the anime ZOM 100. Like just now, we just watched it. What is it?
Bucket List of the Dead.
Bucket List of the Dead, is that the full title?
ZOM 100, Bucket List of the Dead is the full title.
And I believe you and I, when we were going over like the anime that are coming out this season, we were like, oh, this sounds interesting. So I know that I've been specifically waiting to watch it with you. Have you watched any episodes yet?
No, because I heard about the new format. I've actually been holding off on anime I want to talk about.
Whoops.
Which is definitely my excuse for why I haven't watched any anime.
I know my thoughts from the trailer. What are yours? What are you expecting from watching the trailer?
So it's a, you know, short version, but you know, it's an anime about a guy who goes through corporate burnout, joins a company, burns out because he gets overworked. It's apparently a common thing in Japan, but then hey, zombies. And I love the energy of it. It's super colorful, which is not common with zombie stuff. Zombie stuff is usually like very gray, lots of blood, all of that, but like the trailer has tons of color. The thumbnail for the anime, or like the main like image for the anime, again, is super colorful. There's, you know, a bunch of stuff all over. It looks fun, and I might have found a Gigguk video specifically about this from like 2 years ago, which is when you're glad everyone around you is dead.
I saw that. I think from what I've seen online, because I've watched a few guys, we're nerds, we watch other anime YouTubers. Gigguk is definitely one of them, and I've seen one or two of his videos. I haven't seen the one on the manga yet. I've been avoiding it because, well, anime. So from the trailer for me, I'm excited, but I also have concerns.
Uh-huh.
So I'm excited because something that I never expected to happen in my entire life is I love zombie stuff, but it's not the zombie bits that I normally like. It's the stories that seem to come up when you throw a cast of modern day characters into this like post-apocalyptic world where it's our world that we recognize, but everything's different. Mm-hmm. And then the zombies are just like the things that attack and you have to fight. I don't as much like it when there are horror bits to the zombie stuff. And this anime definitely does not seem like it is being targeted as a horror anime at all. So I am excited about that. What I'm concerned about is I am worried that it might be taking a spoof comedy approach. And in the past, I haven't really enjoyed a lot of spoof anime. Like a really good example is one that you loved, Sharko, and that I will one day watch the next two episodes of. And that's the I Have No Magic, So I Worked Out for 1,000 Days, then I'm that, Rock Lee in a wizard world.
That is not the plot at all, but we'll deal with that.
Look, half of you know exactly what I'm talking about, and the other half are like, what the fuck? So I'm worried it's going to take a comedy approach, but if it doesn't, because it looks like it could also just take a shonen-esque approach. Mm-hmm. And if we have a shonen-style zombie anime where the main character has rediscovered his desire to live because everybody around him has turned into zombies so he doesn't have to go to work, I mean, okay, sure.
I see the concern that maybe it's comedy-esque, and I think there will be comedic parts to it, but I don't think that's the focus of it.
And comedic parts are completely fine. Like, I like to laugh, yeah. You guys. I promise I like to laugh. It's when the whole point of the anime. I used to call it like American cartoon humor, but I don't think that's what it is. Slapstick humor? I don't know. I don't know what it's called, but it's when the whole point of this is funny because it's so dumb bothers me on a fundamental level. But that, I don't know. I'm not getting that from this trailer. I'm just a little concerned that might be the direction it takes.
That's an understandable concern.
Definitely looks like we've got a waifu though, and I'm excited about the waifu.
Yeah, waifus are fine. You don't need a waifu.
You don't need one. But if you have one, and if the waifu just also so happens to be engaging.
That's the question. Is the waifu good?
Yeah.
Because there are plenty of waifus where you're just like, all right, they're, you're here. Cool.
When the writing can write everything but the females.
Listen, I got spoiled last year with the best waifu.
Who's the best waifu?
Marin, Jessup Darling.
I wonder if we're ever going to get a second season.
I'm probably going to start reading the manga soon.
Yeah, it's probably a good idea. Anyway, we have seen the trailer. We've talked about the trailer. We have our thoughts. We have our hopes. We have our dreams. Do you have any concerns about the trailer?
Not so far.
All right. Now, Salvo and I are going to go and watch the first 3 episodes of this anime. For us, it'll be about an hour and a half. But for you guys, it'll be right about... And just like that, we're back. See, it wasn't very long for you guys at all. But... Salvo Sharko and I, we just finished watching the first 3 episodes of Zom 100.
Yes, we did.
And, well, it is not what I was worried about. It is definitely not purely a comedy.
It's some shonen zombie bullshit.
It is definitely some shonen zombie bullshit.
But, like, in the best of ways.
But during episode 1, one of the first things I wrote down was that the art style reminds me of the My Hero Academia art style.
Yeah, I can see that.
Like, the main character kind of makes me think a little, reminds me a little bit of Deku, after Deku gains some confidence.
See that. Very, very, very different personality, but, like, visually, I can see that a lot.
But, like, one of the first things episode 1 did was just destroy my worries that this was going to be a comedy. It actually... So we're going to go into some spoilers a little bit, I guess. So spoiler warning. If you haven't watched the first 3 episodes, just stop right now. We'll wait. Go watch the first 3 episodes and then come back, because they're definitely worth watching. Like, the art is beautiful. The music is just on point everywhere. And the show's good.
Yeah, it's enjoyable.
Like, one of the as we're opening up, you've got this main character who, he's fresh out of college, he's super excited, and he has just started what he believes to be the job of his dreams.
And it's soft, kind of nice, but you know how it's gonna end.
Yeah, and it also, I know I've been in a situation like that before. I don't know if you have or not, I'm sure you have, Salva, where when you don't, you're in a new location, whether it be a new job or a new club or a new classroom, anything that is a new environment, surrounded by other people, and your first impression is, wow, everybody is just really super nice and welcoming and helpful. And then after the shiny new feeling washes away, you realize none of that was true.
Well, it's kind of like the masks come off. And all of a sudden, it's just the, oh, I see.
And they do a really good job of showing this super optimistic guy, half a kid, half an adult, going from so much energy to just effectively becoming a corporate zombie. And yeah. My first thought, because usually like things like this happen, and my first thought is, well, why don't you just quit? Find a different job. But the episode actually goes into that, how in the beginning, yes, everyone is super welcoming and inviting. And yeah, okay, so we pulled an extreme all-nighter, but my supervisor, he just treated me to dinner. And yes, the manager yells at us a lot, but he's just really, really energetic about the job. And if I work hard enough, I'm gonna go up. And this is just something that I have to get used to. And after all, there are all of these benefits. Like, you have all of this vacation time and sick days and paid time off. And then you realize that nobody is able to use them. And then, yeah. And then he says, go ahead.
there's a lot of like really, really bad things that get done to manipulate people into continuing to do that, to continue staying there and being a part of that.
He says the one phrase that I used, that hit home, like straight home for me. And that was, if I quit, it'll be on the shoulders of the rest of my team to pick up my slack.
That's the big one. It gets used a lot.
And I did use that. I was at one point, I was in a job where before I started the job, I was told, hey, you could work anywhere from 30 hours to 0 hours. And she really emphasized the like 0 hours. It really felt like it was going to be when we need you, we'll call you kind of a thing. And then I started working there and they're like, no. You're going to be, even though you applied for a flexible part-time job, you will be working 30 hours a week because we are severely understaffed and you will be working 30 hours a week every week. And you kind of can't take time off because we are severely understaffed.
Yeah, it's that constant thing of like, you need to be here. I don't care that we told you this other stuff. You need to be here.
And it was a very, like, there were a few times where my husband was like, why don't you just quit? And I'm like, well, because if I quit, it might shut down because we won't have enough people.
So anyways, corporations are fucked.
But it was just, I don't know, when he said that line that I can't quit, I can't take time off because I'll let my team down. I think that's a really big mindset that a lot of, I think yours and my generation have, Salvo. The whole, it's important to get a job and you should be grateful for any job that you get. And once you have that job, you want to keep that job. And if you do not keep that job, you are letting your team X, Y, and Z down.
Or it's that idea that, you know, if you're not willing to do this very specific style of like really difficult job, that you're lazy.
Right. I think it's important. And I honestly believe a lot of the generation that came after us is going into the workforce with a similar mentality to this. But if your job has put you in a position where you are being overworked and underpaid, and if you quit, it will be to the detriment of your teammates and all of that stuff, that's not on you. That is your job letting you down.
And most of your coworkers will understand.
Or are having the same feelings.
That's also fair.
And when you go in for a job interview, I know my mindset was always like, oh my gosh, am I going to get this job? I need a job. Am I going to get this job? Will I pass this interview? As if it were like passing an audition or something. And it's not. The interview, it goes both ways.
Yeah.
Like, I was applying to a job a few years ago when I first started developing this mindset. And I was like, hey, you know, I need a job that will allow me to work this very specific hour set. The person that was interviewing me was like, oh, well, at first, you're probably going to be working a lot of this very specific shift. And that shift was the exact opposite of what I needed. And she's like, it's just, this is the shift that everybody works at first. And then I went, okay, well, then unfortunately, I do not think this is going to be the job for me. And I will have to pass.
Yeah, it's that idea of, okay, well, bye.
She was very confused. I think she was expecting me to go, oh, okay, that's fine. And it wasn't fine. My whole point in all of this was episode one does a really good job of showing how someone can over time just devolve with the mindset of working in a toxic work environment.
No, that's completely fair.
And then we get to the end of episode one and the zombie outbreak starts.
And it's just so freeing and colorful and full of movement. It's honestly like such a tonal shift, but in the best of ways.
This man rugby rushes a zombie three times his size right out of a father mucking window.
Oh, that should not have happened. That man should have died.
Wait, oh my God. It was...
But it felt good.
I actually, after episode one, I actually went and I looked up what studio was doing this because it was some studio trigger levels of just chaotic amazing. Like this was a mine is the drill that will pierce the heavens level of excitement and hype. And it's not by Studio Trigger. It is by Studio Bug?
Never heard of them.
That's because this is the first anime they've done.
Right. You mentioned that.
So that's super exciting. And I just, goodness, I got so hyped. And so, of course, naturally, episode 2 starts and we have a complete and total tone shift.
A little. And they handle it well.
Yeah. They honestly wonderfully emulate the overworked, burnt out, just exhausted person finally just going, I'm done.
Yeah.
And so you have this dude who's like, I'm out of beer. I'm gonna go get some beer. And then he's crawling down like the water vein thingy and he's waving to his neighbors and they're like, there's a zombie apocalypse. And he's like, yeah, I know. It's great, isn't it?
Yeah, do you guys want anything from the convenience store?
But then when he returns, those neighbors are dead.
Which is kind of surprising, if I'm honest. It looked like they would have been all right.
Right? And then he sits down and he writes a list of all the things that he wants to do.
A bucket list, if you will.
Bucket list, if you will. And it's stuff like, I want to go live at home.
I want to go see my parents.
I want to hang out with my best friend.
Yeah, just really soul-crushing stuff.
And so you have these beats of, yes, this character is in a, I finally don't have to go to work mania. I can do whatever I want. And then you see the flashes of the very real consequences of the world around him.
It's a show that I honestly appreciate that for the most part, they ignore a lot of like, okay, well, he's got to get food. He's got to get, you know, resources, things like that. He's got to worry about that stuff. They bring it up briefly with another character, the waifu, if you will.
Yes, I like her.
But like, it's not something we're stressed about. It's not something we're really like worried about.
I feel like, and this may change because we are 3 episodes into what I'm assuming is at least a 12 episode anime series. I'm guessing much longer than that. It doesn't really seem to be a survival-based zombie apocalypse anime. It really seems to be using the zombie apocalypse thing to be a commentary on how easily your entire life can get away from you. Like the whole, oh yeah, man, I'd love to go and watch this anime series with my buddy, but all this stuff with life is getting in the way, so I'm just gonna put it off.
Yeah, it's really good.
Look, of everything that I was expecting to come from this anime, depth wasn't 3 of them.
Oh, yeah, fair.
Also, oh my god, you guys, this is a shonen style anime where the main character is neither obnoxiously overpowered, but he is also competent. It is so freaking nice to see an anime where you have things like, oh, people are dying around you. Ray Zero, stuff like that. And instead of shutting down and screaming and not knowing what to do and being completely useless, the main character is just like, all right, time to jump off a roof.
Yeah, he's a fun character.
He's so much fun to watch. And it's just so, like, obviously he has a lot of room to grow, but it is so nice to see a main character like this that's not like, you know, this character is completely useless, but he's real nice. He's also watched a lot of zombie stuff, so he kind of knows how to navigate a world like this, which I also really appreciated.
But yeah, no, I like him. I think he's fun. I like that, you know, part of, you know, episode 3, going to find his best friend is apologizing for the mistakes he made.
Right? They get, yeah, even if he does so very loudly.
Yeah, he should not have shouted.
But hey, also, did I forget to mention, it may be obvious at this point, but so far, almost every single character in the show is an adult.
Yeah.
I'm not thinking about the amount of kids who are dead at this point in the show.
No, and none of that has been really, like, shown. It's always been, look at the dead adults.
Yeah, it's a very adult-centered anime, and I, as an adult, appreciate seeing something so shonen-oriented. Seinen is the actual branding I think it's been given.
Uh-huh.
But it's still, like, it's written for adults, written to adults, but it's got a lot of themes from anime that I really enjoyed growing up.
Mm-hmm. It's a lot of fun. It's very enjoyable.
Honestly,
I'm not gonna lie.
I would say 10 out of 10 passes the vibe check.
Absolutely.
Wait, no, 9 out of 10. There is no dub. But yeah, so that has been our opinion from the first 3 episodes. And after watching the trailer of Zom 100, if you watched this and got things spoiled because you didn't watch the first 3 episodes, I'm sorry. I don't think we spoiled too much. But if you hadn't watched it, are you going to? And if you have, what did you think? Like, are you as hyped about this anime as we are?
And expect to hear more from this if we keep up with it.
Oh, we're going to keep up with it. In fact, there's an episode 4 out. Salvo, would you like to go watch it, like, right now?
I could be convinced.
All right, bye, guys!
Bye.